us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord. A word from the Lord.
Our message entitled, just one appealing word to people from the with Lord. Gentleness. Appealing to people with doubt. Gentleness. We're going to look and at 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 1 through 6. Let's read this together on three. It's two slides, and this is the NIV. Let's read this together on three. One, two, three.
By the meekness and gentleness of Christ, I appeal to you. I, Paul, who am timid, when face to face with you, but bold went away. I beg you that when I come, I may not have to be as bold as I expect to be towards some people who think that we live by the standards of this world. For though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world. On the contrary, they have mind power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God. And we take captive every thought to make it obedience to Christ. And we will be ready to punish every act of disobedience once your obedience is complete.
Amen. Tonight again, we're going to talk about appealing to people with gentleness. We're going to talk about the softness of gentleness. We're going to talk about the standards of gentleness. We're going to talk about the stronghold of gentleness. We want you to know tonight that Christians should be gentle with standards. Mm-hmm. Christians should be gentle with standards. Point number one, the softness of gentleness. I can remember a commercial by thetruth.com, and it was a commercial that posed the question, do you have what it takes to be a tobacco industry executive? And this executive was in his office interviewing a young lady, and he was saying to her, are you willing to do this? Or are you willing to do that? As he talked about the poisons that were in the tobacco products. And the young lady said, with all softness and gentleness, she said, oh no, I'll never do that. Oh no, I'll never do that. I couldn't help but to think that it's a good example of the message that we're trying to convey tonight. We're trying to convey tonight the message of being gentle, but at the same time having standards. Right. In other words, God is not calling you to be a pushover because you are gentle. God is not calling you to be a doormat because you are gentle. Again, let's look at point number one, the softness of gentleness. It says, as Paul was trying to appeal to the church there in Corinth, he says, by the meekness and gentleness of Christ, I appeal to you. He says, Paul, who I am timid when face to face with you, but bold away. Every great man of God, people try to discredit their ministry and try to point out their weaknesses and try to say that they are not qualified to do what they're, what people believe them to be doing. And Paul is like most great men of God. The thing of which they criticize Paul for is that he was very timid in person. As a matter of fact, I see and hear some preachers and teachers not really knowing the nature of Paul, and they say that I wish I could preach like Paul. Paul was not a good preacher. Paul came across in his natural day, instead of being the Superman that he's like in his writings, in person he was more like Clark Kent. And so people began to criticize him and his ministry and try to discredit him as being a real apostle. They tried to say that he was not real because he's not like Apollos. Now, Apollos was impressive in person. He was a great orator. And if you wanted to hear somebody preach, Apollos was the one that you would go listen to, but you would read the writings of Paul. You'd read the writings of Paul. So right here, Paul begins to kind of stick up for himself. But as he was sticking up for himself, he says, by meekness, and meekness is strength under control.
All right. Mm.
Meekness, a good illustration of what meekness is some of you are on the farm and you try to break horses. And a horse that is not broken is a horse that won't let you sit on its back, so you can't use his strength. But a horse that is broken, a good word for that is that he'll let you sit on his back, and that is meekness. Meekness is strength under control. And the text says that Paul, with his strength under control and with gentleness of Christ. Gentleness is softness. Gentleness is the picture of, at the beginning, as you see on the bulletin there, as we talk about gentleness, you'll see a flower and a little bubble and how they're meeting one another, but the flower doesn't bust the bubble. Okay? That's gentleness. So that's softness. So we talk about the softness of gentleness. And then when you talk about Sunday, Proverbs 15:1, and this is what Paul was trying to do. A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words start up anger. And we, as the people of God, must learn to appeal to one another in all meekness and gentleness so that we might accomplish the work and the will of God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So that was the softness of gentleness. Point number two is the standards of gentleness. You see, Paul had to deal with some real issues, especially with this Corinthian church. This Corinthian church was one of the most gifted church in the New Testament, but it also was one of the most carnal churches in the New Testament. The most carnal church in the New Testament. So Paul had to deal with some issues. He said, I beg you that when I come, that I may not have to be as bold as I expect to be towards some people who think that we live by the standards of the world. He says, now, I can be meek, I can be gentle, but I also have some standards. And the standards are the standards of the Word of God. That is the only standard. And if you are not living the Word of God, then I have to get a little bit more bold and I have to confront you and the things that you are doing.
On the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction. From above, we